Hi guys, today's video is a surprise one. we call it triple fun, because we're gonna fly three jets today. We start with Black Horse Viper, and these jets are very special, so bear with us. We start with Black Horse Viper, then we have one or two flights with Avanti, small one, the Foamy, and then in the end the Odyssey again. And every jet has a special setup. Black Horse Viper, I used to fly on 12S 100 amps, it was nice. And this ESC is a 100 amp 12S ESC from Sunrise. And also BEC circuit is 12S from Sunrise. But a few days ago, on the other airfield, I tried something else. I have put to this Black Horse Viper the battery from the Odyssey. So it's not 12, but 14S. 14S, 12 milliampere hours battery, so a strong battery. When I was connecting, I was waiting for a big spark and flames, but nothing happened. So I flew twice, and it flies great. It has more than 7 kilowatts, so from 4 kilowatts we advanced to more than 7, I think 7.5 kilowatts. It flies wonderful. I have to cool it down from time to time, because the ESC is only 100 amp 12S. And I'm pushing 135 amps on 14S from it. But the jet flies marvelous. And I hope it will fly now, that nothing will break, and we will continue and we'll complete the flight, because it's still kind of cold, because it's morning, it's like 8 degrees. But that's why we came in the morning. So we cool the stuff, we cool the ESC. And the motor also, it's only 460 gram motor, and we are pulling more than seven kilowatts from it, so it's kind of on the edge. That's why I have to manage the throttle, but I think the flight will be exciting. Then the Avanti is with the new ESC and the new motor, 2600 kV, pulling 165 amps on 6S on full battery. So it's 3.2 kilowatts on full battery. It's 1 kilowatt more, it's much stronger. I flew it also. It's tearing the sky, it's unbelievable. It's so fast, it's unbelievable. It's exciting. Okay, and then the Odyssey in the end, I've changed the ESC for a different one. I'll speak about this later. It doesn't have the cutoff, the fail-safe mechanism, so it's really hot. I tried it back home. It's really hot, but it works. And I'm not sure if we fly on 3 or 4 batteries, 4S, the 14S, we'll see. But definitely the flight will be exciting. So it's something new about all the jets. So no more talking, it's enough. Let's fly.
Amps, 122 amps, 116 amps, 39.1 amps, 41.8 amps, 126 amps, 122 amps, 122 amps, 125 amps, 44.8 amps. 226 kilometers per hour. 4.8 amps, 1,356 watts. Milliamp hours. Volts, 36 volts. Volts, 36 volts, 7,263 milliamp hours. 119 amps, 2.6 volts, 2.8 volts, 3.7 volts, gear down, 148 kilometers per hour, 127 kilometers per hour, 9,254 milliamp hours, 130 kilometers per hour, flaps full, 90 kilometers per hour, 90 kilometers per hour, 83 kilometers per hour, 73 kilometers per hour, 64 kilometers per hour, 9,278 milliamp hours.
The Black Horse Viper flight was very nice. The ESC didn't burn. The maximum ampere draw was 141 on 14S. So a lot of power, I think 7.5 kilowatts at least. You could see during the flight, the vertical is unlimited almost. It's so nice. In the end of the flight, I was going straight up on the empty battery. It's super nice. I think I will change the ESC to a stronger one and then burn the motor. So I would need to change the motor to for a heavier one, because this motor will burn for sure, because it's 460 grams. And 7.5 kilowatts is a lot. Okay, yeah, but it was fun. The top speed without diving, because we were not diving, was 230 kilometers per hour fast. And a few days ago, I was diving a little bit like I normally do, and I clocked 274 kilometers per hour with Black Horse Viper on GPS. Very fast. Okay, so it was exciting, very low passes. And now we are flying the Freewing Avanti. On new setup, it's instead of 2,300, it's 2,600 kV motor, 320 grams, and the stronger ESC, this ESC is 160 amps to 185 amps. But I tried it yesterday back home and the 160 amps works perfect. So I guess everything will work nice here and I will try to push hard. And we have a pitot tube, so we'll check the top speed. Yeah, so we fly this jet and then maybe again this one and then the Odyssey. Okay, let's fly. Straight up. Okay, let's fly. Land because my expo is
gear down.
It's too lazy.
Flaps full, 120 kilometers per hour, 103 kilometers per hour, 85 kilometers per hour, 76 kilometers per hour, 66 kilometers per hour.
We have, 3 minutes flight already. Straight up. Unbelievable. It's 3 kilowatts now. It's so nice. No, it's too much. I have to readjust my expo.
Gear down. Flaps full, 120 kilometers per hour. 101 kilometers per hour. 85 kilometers per hour. 74 kilometers per hour. 60 kilometers per hour. 62 kilometers per hour. Thank you. 13.6 volts.
Okay, landing.
Gear down. Flaps full. 124 kilometers per hour. 124 kilometers per hour. 97 kilometers per hour. 76 kilometers per hour. 66 kilometers per hour. Flaps half.
Sucking the battery much quicker. What is the time of the flight now? 4 minutes. But 4 minutes we're pulling constantly above 150 amps. The full battery is 165 and the empty battery is 150. Cooling down. Lots more.
Kilometers per hour. 93 kilometers per hour. 85 kilometers per hour. 68 kilometers per hour. 58 kilometers per hour.
It was very funny flights. My brother standing behind the camera, he said that adjusting, you know, getting used to this small, fast jet after the big jet is unbelievable. He couldn't keep up with this beast. It's so fast, but I'm sure he did. So compliments to my brother, which is standing behind the camera, thanks. And guys, this 3.2 kilowatts in this small jet is unbelievable. I don't think even, you know, the speed is one thing, the agility is one thing, but also maybe you saw the, you noticed few low passes. I don't think you can go any lower. I had few times 20 cm above the ground with speed 200 kilometers per hour and didn't crash. So it was luck. I'm very lucky. I am super, super pleased with this setup because I'm flying still on 3 batteries, like on the last setup, but I'm just pulling more amps from them, and I checked, they're cold, not so warm, so they're handling 50 plus amps well, because I opened the cheater holes, the vent holes for the batteries, so they're being vented constantly, and of course the flight is shorter. It was 4 minutes full throttle and then 2 minutes cooling down in the end, so 6 minutes flight, still long, but the batteries survived, the ESC survived, although I have a feeling that because it's a new ESC for me, first time I use this brand, I opened it and it looks nice, very strong, everything looks solid. But during the flight, when I was closing the landing gear, the voltage on the BEC came down from 5.1 to 4.9. There is a little sag on the BEC, but I have to test it more, so I'll let you know. But the ESC, there will be a description of the components in the description of the video and the link to the shop that I bought it. It's an inexpensive ESC and a strong one. The motor survived. This plane is so much harder to fly than the big ones, especially so fast, because it's fast and it's small and it's agile, but it's a lot of fun. I really, really enjoyed it. And wow, the top speed. We didn't dive so much, but I have to check.
220 kilometers per hour.
Yeah, but we're not going for fast runs, because at this Cuban 8 that I was doing in the sky, I was releasing the throttle a little bit to, I don't remember anymore. Yeah, but we were not going for the speed, it was just level flight. So level flight 220, comparing to level flight 200 on the standard motor that I used to fly. So it's 20 more, and I bet if I dive from high altitude, it would be 260 or 280, 280 kilometers per hour, I'm sure, because this motor is just way stronger. So great setup, I love it. The plane is wonderful, it's just super nice. I think we have to cut the grass because it's already so long that the plane takes off barely with these small wheels. Yeah, but we're cutting today. Okay, enough talking about this and the final flight of today. We are flying the Odyssey, and I'm not sure yet if we fly on 3 batteries like last time, 14S, or on 4. We'll see very soon. Okay, see you soon.
Amps, 87 amps, 90 amps, 194 amps, 181 amps, 8,708 watts, 89 amps, 79 amps, 182 amps, 179 amps, 188.
cooling down the ESC in the air.
Watts, 7,449 watts. 5 amps. 151 amps. 12,000 milliamp hours, 39 volts. Gear down. Flaps full. Oh, 1,266 milliamp hours.
So guys, we have all the flights in. The Odyssey was flying marvelous. I was a bit scared that the ESC will burn and we'll have a fire, but nothing happened. I was managing the throttle. Because the ESC, I removed the Hobby Wing Funfly 160 amp ESC because the failsafe is just making me crazy. I didn't enjoy this ESC. And I had in my shelf, I've put the ZTW or ZTW 12S 150 amp ESC, slightly smaller, slightly lighter, but it managed superb and it doesn't have the failsafe, so I could push as much as I wanted. And we were flying on four batteries in parallel 14S, And we had exactly a takeoff 206 amps, and exactly 10 kilowatts. So, and I had extensive stretches of full throttle, and the ESC survived. So I'm super pleased. I checked it yesterday on the shell, on the table back home, and it was warm for a touch. I think it was around 60 Celsius, but it didn't burn. And I was trying it yesterday on 3 batteries, and today it's outside, so the cooling is better. And it was 4 batteries, and it survived superbly. So I can recommend this ESC to everyone. The ZTW 150 amp 12S ESC, superb ESC, very nice. And flight time was almost 8 minutes, so super nice. And I think top speed, I don't have the pitot tube or the GPS installed, but I think it was a top speed was about 240, maybe 250 k's per hour, 240. So it's very fast. Of course, this jet wants a stronger setup. So I already bought yesterday the 20S 300 to 400 amp ESC. Of course, I will not use it at 20S, but I'm thinking for this Odyssey 16S or 18S, 200 amps. So it will be around 13 kilowatts. I think it will be perfect. It will be super nice. Now it was nice. It was very safe and easy to fly because the jet was climbing. Everything was nice. The jet feels much, Odyssey felt much lighter with this power. But I think 13 or 14 kilowatts will be perfect for this jet. It will feel like a small Avanti. Okay. So, and I didn't say one thing. On this one, I'm flying the SS motor on everyone. No, this one SS motor, this is head motor, and this is SSS motor. But on this one, I'm flying the JP 120. On the Odyssey, I'm flying JP 120 rotor, aluminium rotor. I would love a bigger one, 150 or 140, but it's hard to buy with reasonable price. So I stick with this aluminium one. It's a nice one. On Viper, we are flying Vemotec 100, which is the best sound of all EDFs I've ever found. The Odyssey sounds great, but the Black Horse Viper with the Vemotec is just mind-blowing. It sounds like a real turbine. It's super nice. I really enjoy it. Super nice. And in Avanti, we have 80 millimeter Vemotec. I didn't balance it super well, but it's good. It's very nice. Okay. So we had triple fun today. It's a long video. I hope you enjoyed it. And I enjoyed it a lot. It was a beautiful morning and successful one because we didn't crash. And it was close calls, few close calls we had during these flights. So I think this is it. I will make descriptions of the components under the video. And I just remind everyone, I have landing gear that I designed and printed on my 3D printer, and this plane is 15 and a half or 16 kilos, and it's super nice. It's landing so nice. So I encourage everyone to sit in front of the computer, design your own landing gear and try it, because you can play really nice. It's a lot of fun. Okay, thank you so much. One more thing, the most important. I'm looking for a pilot, preferably a girl, for my Odyssey. If any one of you has a spare pilot for a big jet like that, or knows where I can buy a pilot, not for 500 euro, but with reasonable price, or if somebody has a 3D file for printing a pilot, I would be grateful. Thank you so much, and I hope to see you next time.